Before I started watching this movie yesterday, I went in with a different mindset than how I viewed the trailers for this movie, how I viewed the promotional clips, how I viewed every bit of advertising that they were promoting for this movie. I went in with a different mindset. I went with the mindset that, you know what? This is not this is not an exact adaptation of the original Death Note. If I did want a live action adaptation of the original Death Note that's actually faithful to its source material, I would have just watched the Death Note Japanese films, because those even though, you know, they do change details here and there up, it still has the basic idea of the original Death Note story. It pays respects to it, it's faithful for the most part, and it's an enjoyable film nonetheless. So if I really did want to see like a more similar, more faithful to the source material adaptation of Death Note, I would have just watched that. But I still did want to watch this because I wanted to express my opinion to you all, because I know not everyone is going to see the Japanese film. They're going to probably look into, because most American fans, most European fans, they're probably just going to watch a fully English translated one. They're not going to watch one with subs. They're going to watch one that's made in America, made in Europe, made in Canada, whatever. And, you know, that's what this movie is. It's not a direct adaptation of the original Death Note source material. As a matter of fact, it says at the beginning, like, this is the case with almost every single movie. It says, based on something, something, something. In this case, you know, it was based on Death Note and Shonen Jump or something like that. So it is based off the original source material. It is not the original source material in live action. It's someone else's take on this and how they would envision it if it were to be in live action, if it were to be in a little more modern setting, even though you could argue Death Note's pretty modern. But for the most part, you know, in like, in America, I guess I don't feel like that's the right phrase, but that's just one I can come up with at the top of my head. So I think this movie does get a little too much hate because people went in with a different mindset than, you know, like then if they were to actually watch the anime. Now, when I was watching the anime, I thought it was perfect. For the most part, the first like 2/3 were in my eyes, like, just fantastic, one of the best pieces of anime I've ever seen. And with this movie, I thought it was okay. I would give it, after watching it, I said on Twitter it was like a 7 or 7.5 out of 10. I think I'll lower it a little bit to maybe a 6 out of 10. Because, yeah, it has flaws, and the flaws are kind of bad, but I feel for the most part this movie is getting trashed on way much more than it should have, because this movie, at the end of the day, if you look at it as an adaptation of Death Note, then, yeah, it's not that great. If you look at its own standalone film, it's, not bad. It's okay. As its own individual film, while also having certain elements of the adaptation to pay homage to the original, it's not a bad film. It's not a bad film. So I'm giving it that solid 6 out of 10, and that's actually being a little bit generous, after, like, fully reevaluating it and stuff, because there were certain elements of the film that I personally really enjoyed that I don't think other people are really thinking about all that much. The issue is with the film primarily was with the two main characters. And the thing is, though, is that the movie focuses them on them a lot and kind of their relationship. So it's, yeah, so it's not really the most positive thing that's it's really going to bring the movie down, you can tell. So, yeah, let's just get right into it. This is going to be a very long review. It's actually my second time recording. Okay, so yesterday, after I was done watching the movie, I recorded a review, but, you know, my internet went out because, you know, Hurricane Harvey's going on right now. I'm recording this second take while the weather's still cleared and everything like that. I'm safe in case anyone's curious. For any of my fellow Texans, be sure to stay safe for Hurricane Harvey. And back to the subject, though. After I was done, you know, with my review, and after, like, really thinking about it, I was like, you know what? Yeah, I feel like I was a little too generous. Like, I don't mean to sound extremely negative, and I hate to jump on the bandwagon that, yeah, this movie's the worst thing ever, but I feel like the movie got a lot of undeserved hate, and it also got a lot of undeserved praise for me. It's kind of like in that middle-ish area, slightly good, just okay is the best way to describe it. And when I was viewing the trailers and everything, I was like, yeah, this movie's going to be awful. Awful, I tell you. And it wasn't awful. It was okay. I feel like I've been saying, just people going with the mindset, yeah, this is Dragon Ball Evolution. This is Dragon Ball Evolution. This is supposed to be exactly like the original Death Note. It wasn't exactly like the original Death Note. Screw this movie. Like, if you went in with that mindset, you probably did hate it, I can tell. I went in with the fact that, you know what? They changed a good portion of the characters' names. For example, Light Turner is not Light Yagami for the most part. Sure, he's based off Light Yagami. Heck, they both share the same first name, but the last names are changed as well. James Turner is not Soichiro Yagami. He's based off Soichiro Yagami, but it's their own. But it's his own character. Ryuk is Ryuk, and he's actually one of the best parts of the film, I'm not gonna lie. L is L. They share the same name, they share a certain same traits and stuff, and for the most part, it blends well with everyone's character and stuff. So I see this film as, yeah, this is not, I went with the fact that these are new protagonists. I even said in like my last bit of Death Note coverage that, you know what, if they just went in with a completely different name, a name for a protagonist, the movie probably, I would have been more positive towards it. And you know what, I went in with that mindset. I'm like, yeah, this is not Light Yagami. This is not Light Yagami. And you know what? I was like, okay, yeah. I got some enjoyment out of the film when I went in with a more positive mindset. So even with this positive mindset, the movie isn't that great. I'm telling you, like I said, it's okay. All right? I would still give it a watch at the end of the day, because a lot of people are saying, no, never watch this film, never watch this film. It's still worth a watch if you're a fan of Death Note. If you're not a fan of Death Note, watch the original series. Actually, you know what? Watch this movie and then watch the original series. It'll make you appreciate the original series way more, trust me. And, oh yeah, by the way, this review is gonna have spoilers. So, yeah, if you haven't seen it yet, just go on Netflix, watch it, and then watch the original series right afterwards. Because I'm also going to be talking about the original series spoilers. So, just be familiar with the original series or have a basic idea. Or, if you don't care about being spoiled, whatever. Generally, though, I will say, this movie captured certain characters fine. This movie also captured certain characters in a way to where, yeah, it's just a new protagonist overall. And I'm like, okay, yeah, that's what it is. That's what it is. Whatever. Okay. Let's talk about some of the better parts of the film, like better characters. Let's talk about L and Ryuk. L surprised me. I knew Ryuk was going to be great because William Dafoe is a fantastic actor and he did not disappoint. I feel like every role that William Dafoe plays, he's not really meant for a hero. He's meant for a villain. He's meant for the creepy anti-hero type. And with how he portrayed Ryuk, I'm like, yep, you are Ryuk. You are Ryuk, dude. Not only with the way you sound, it sounds very similar to the English dub. And it also sounds like he captured the personality of Ryuk, and for the most part, the writing that the writers, you know, wrote on stuff, I was like, yeah, this worked. This is Ryuk one way or the other. I don't envision anyone else. Now, a lot of people didn't like Ryuk because he was getting too involved with Light's actions, and at the same time, in the original, Ryuk was very much so looking at Light. He was observing Light, and I personally didn't mind this new take on him because, yeah, he's doing some things that would actually be considered illegal in the original Death Note, which is funny because a Shinigami can't write another human's name, and if they do, they die, essentially. Look what happened with Rem. And, you know, they didn't do that here. Ryu just wrote names just to mess around with Light. I think it still fit well with his character. He wanted to have some fun. He wanted to see Light get triggered. Because at the end of the day, Ryuk in the original even tells him, yeah, Light, I'm gonna be the one writing your name. Ryuk is not your friend, and Ryuk is not your pet. They even foreshadow that at the beginning of this film. They also show that in the original Death Note. So I thought Ryuk was really well portrayed. Also, the way he looked too, I was like, dang, yeah, that's certainly something. Yeah, and no, it's no wonder that Light was terrified about him. But then again, Light is sort of a con about this film, so we'll get to him when we get to him. What else is there? Oh yeah, L is easily one of the best parts of the film. I think a good reason for this was that he surprised me. He surprised a lot of the viewers. A lot of people aren't talking about him because I think a lot of people like are too focused on the negative aspect. But I'm like, you know what? That guy playing L did a good job. He captured the spirit of L. And sure, he doesn't look like the original L, but does that really matter? As long as he captures the personality, as long as he captures the spirit, as long as we can see that, yeah, this guy's L, that's all I need. You know, you can change a few things here and there, because Japan anime and manga, they don't always transfer over to, you know, American comics and movies and whatever. But, you know, they were still able to retain good enough things from the original Death Note. They were able to keep that. There were also some, I feel like, yeah, that didn't make as much sense, but that's mostly revolving around Light. L himself, though, L works. L, not only did he capture, you know, the signature sitting position of L, although I think that was mostly a writer's thing, he also had the candy addiction. He also had this weird vibe to him, this little, like, awkward tone that makes us love L so much, you know? And when I was watching it, I even said out loud, I'm like, yep, this is L. This is L. This is the L we all know and love. This is the L that I feel made us really enjoy the original Death Note as well. This L was definitely a redeeming factor of the film, and his rivalry with Light, for the most part, I thought it was fine. A lot of other people didn't like it, but I thought it was fine. Could have been better, I can tell, but then again, this movie was only an hour and a half, and yeah, we'll get to it when we get to the cons. So for now, we're just talking about the characters, which is just kind of a weird random order. It's just me giving my thoughts overall. Nothing too, like, crazy in detail or anything. Nothing too organized. Just me rambling on, essentially. What else is there? Yeah, L was pretty well done. He did speak out in public a few times. Like, I noticed, but in the hood, I'm surprised no one really caught him. I didn't really get that. It's like, okay, yeah, sure, you're covering the bottom half of your face, and you're also wearing a hood, but what else is there? I'm pretty sure they're gonna be able to see your eyes, the upper part of your face, whatever. I didn't really get that. Maybe if he wore, like, a legit mask or something that covered his full face, you know, that might have worked a little better. But, because knowing L, you know, you would have had, like, a secret backup plan, but whatever. Yeah. They also, I noticed Watari plays a decent role. He is, sure, he's sort of a plot device, but he also has certain elements, featuring from the original. I think Watari and Ryuk, as you know, Watari is the most similar to how it was in the original adaptation of Death, though, the anime and the manga. Watari is very similar. They capture him just fine. I thought he was well done. Sure, you know, he did die in the movie, but whatever. We saw him. You know, we saw him. He actually, I don't think he had that big of a role in the anime. I think in the manga, he was referenced a little more. But nonetheless, I like how they did Watsuri. James Turner. Soichiro Yagami, I feel, in the original show was very underrated with how, you know, he didn't really kind of suspect his son as kid. He wants to defend his own son and stuff. And James Turner, with the way he did this, the actor who played him did a good enough job. It worked, you know. It's not Soichiro Yagami, and, you know, the names are nothing similar. So essentially, you know, it was based off, yeah, the personality, but it's up to the actor to decide how much of it he's basing it off of, how he retains it, you know, the way he talks, the way he says his lines, stuff like that. And I feel like the actor did it. He may have watched the original Death Note. I don't know if he did. I think he did an alright job with it, because what I noticed as I was watching, I'm like, I was just viewing it, and I'm like, yeah, you are Soichiro Yagami. I know you are. I know your names are completely different, but you fit well with him. And there's also one line that he says. It's like, or it's something along those lines where it's kind of like, yeah, there's no really such thing as true justice in this world. So we're kind of in the middle here, as you know, as that's my job. So I was like, yeah, you're actually giving him, you're giving him his own identity, Death Note movie. I'm like, yeah, that works. I don't think it was really all that explored in the original series. So I like how they did James. And also, it was kind of interesting that at the end of the movie, he essentially realizes, yeah, like, my son is Kida, one way or the other. And it also leaves up to interpretation, like, is he gonna arrest his son? Is he just gonna let him go? Whatever. I didn't really get this, though, about him. It was mostly about the writing, but he suspects his son is Kida due to one very important clue. It's at, like, the very beginning of the film where, you know, Light, one of the first few things he does is he kills the man who killed Light's mother, which, oh yeah, by the way, I don't mean to go off in a tangent, but Light doesn't have a mother or a sister in this. His mother dies, and I remember in the original, Light had a mother and a sister. So I was like, okay, yeah, that change is interesting, to say the least. I don't think it was a bad change. It didn't really take away anything, and it did actually give Light an extra... It gave him an extra mistake, because only Light and his father knew who actually murdered his mother, and then his father, I feel like he should have learned that from the beginning, but whatever. Maybe he was just, like, not really thinking about it that much in that situation. But once he connected all the dots, it made more sense. So I could see that being the case. What else was there? That's basically covering... That's basically covering the good parts of the characters. They didn't have the officers from the original Death Note, like the deputy officers, the other detectives, I should say, Matsuda and stuff like that, people like him, they weren't really present here, and I'm like, yeah, it's whatever, but it's nothing too big of a deal, because, you know, there was no second half. They were basing this movie off of the L arc, as I like to call it, the first 27 episodes, 27, something like that, mid-20s, I know that for sure. So they were basing it off that, and it worked. I really hope there isn't a sequel, though, and I'll get to that when we talk about the ending, but for now, we're still talking about the characters, Light and Mia. This is gonna be, not gonna be very fun for me. I was talking about the positives of characters, and Light and Mia, it's funny, you're like, yeah, two really bad characters, is that really gonna bring the whole movie down? Well, when the whole movie revolves around them and your main characters are awful, then yeah, it kind of does bring down your movie quite a bit. Like, I feel with how Light and Mia were being betrayed, I understand with how they were doing, you know? Light is obviously, you know, based off Light Yagami. Mia is based on Misa Misa loosely. But I'm saying loosely because really it's only like 20% similar. For the most part, Mia Sudden is completely different from Misa Misa. And Light is very different than Light Yagami. I wouldn't say his character is being fully misinterpreted because it's not Light Yagami. They don't say it's Light Yagami. They say it's Light Turner. An entirely new character based off Light Yagami. So yeah, that's not going well with canon. It's not like Dragon Ball Evolution, where, yeah, Goku, this is not Goku, even though they say it's Goku. Here, they say it's Light, but they don't say it's Light Yagami. They say it's Light Turner. So I'm like, okay, yeah, it's a new protagonist, whatever. But even for a new protagonist, for, like, if this movie, if you don't even think about the original series, the Light Turner's not a good character, honestly. I get what they were doing with it, and same with Mia Sutton, because I understand Light Yagami, or did I just say Light Yagami? Light Turner is based off that aspect of Light Yagami, where he still does make mistakes here and there, where he still does have a conflicting side, like, wait a minute, is this right? But then again, if you did watch the original Death Note, Light, as soon as he gains the power of Death Note, he kind of becomes corrupt, and, he was always had a strong sense of justice, but then the Death Note made him go a little too far with justice, and thus, you know, that's kind of where Mia comes into play. Mia was very corrupt, she was very insane, and her attachment with Light, I could see that being loosely based off Misa Misa, but it wasn't as crazy. Like, I kind of liked how it was in the original. Like, Misa Misa is completely, like, attached to Light. Light's like, yeah, you're clingy, but you share a very important detail that I should probably keep you around. Of course, since this movie's an hour and a half, they couldn't have that important detail with Rem, so essentially, you know, they had to change things around, make it to where only Light could see Ryuk and stuff like that to keep it well-flowing and stuff like that. I keep saying stuff like that so much. I'm sorry. I'll try to lower my usage of that word. What else is there? While we're still on the topic of this, they were so cliche. They were so cliche as a couple. Their relationship felt really forced, especially in, like, the first third of the film. Because there were, like, three acts of the film. There was the first, the second, and the third. And I feel like the second was probably the best part. The third did have, like, probably my favorite scene in the entire film. But nonetheless, you know, the first act was, it was all right. The stuff with Light and Ryuk was interesting, but at the same time, it's like, yeah, it's just, it doesn't really flow as well. But then I'll Let's talk about that once we're done with Light and Mia, because I don't want to talk about these two, but I'm going to talk about these two because they have to be addressed. Light and Mia are so cliche as a couple, gets so annoying as main characters. Not only is it feels like the exact same, I feel like just having maybe Light instead, just have the focus on Light, and then maybe have Mia as like a side character. It didn't always feel that natural, like Light just randomly trusts this stranger. Even when you take away the Light Yagami, Misa aspect, you have to think about, okay, if this is its own standalone movie, if it's not really connected to the original series, which it's not, and if you just look at it at its own independent movie, it still doesn't make any sense. Like, whether you're talking about something based off an anime, which is so wild at times, or whether you're talking about something that's an American movie or something like that, it just doesn't make sense nonetheless. It doesn't seem logical for Light to do this. Light, and what I also don't get is how the ending, I just kind of like the ending, not gonna lie, but with the way the ending worked and with the way, like, how Light acted, it doesn't make sense why he would do this stupid mistake in the beginning. But then again, after the introduction of L, Light started being a little more considerate of his actions and stuff, so there's that. He also has a line of the film to Mia Sutton. It's like, yeah, we're not the good guys anymore. And it kind of goes to show he's kind of conflicted as to why, like, yeah, should I really be going insane with this Death Note? And because he did have the sense of justice, but it wasn't as crazy as it was in the original Death Note. And that's where Mia Sutton comes in. She was just kind of in love with Light, and then also has that insane corrupt side that when you have too much power, you go insane. That's what happened with Mia and the Death Note and stuff. So that's essentially, I said stuff again, didn't I? I'm so sorry. I should create like a counter in the video, like how many times to say stuff in this video. From now on, we're doing like a stuff counter, because I don't feel it. I'm just cutting this part out. I do say stuff a lot. I don't know, man. Let's just keep going with this review though. Light and Mia were whatever. The movie, I understand why they were there, you know, to build a solid, like, main character guy and a main character girl, but I at the same time, I feel, yeah, I get why he did it, but especially in the first act, it just feels so forced. The actors have no chemistry, and it just doesn't work at all. It doesn't, and that's a huge con of the film, and especially when you think about it, like, Light and Misa, you know, they were never that intimate of a relationship, so I guess in this movie, they wanted to put a little more emphasis on that. It's just like, whatever. Light and Misa in the original had, like, a Joker-Harley Quinn relationship. Here, it just felt like a Joker and Harley, but, like, how it was in Suicide Squad, which, they handled that horribly in Suicide Squad, by the way. But yeah, I think it's interesting to note. Yeah, Light and Mia, whatever, huge con of the film. And also, Light, at certain points, I understand, you know, he was terrified of Ryuk. I'm not gonna lie, his scream at the beginning was pretty funny. Like, I couldn't stop laughing. It was like, the actor just went all out. He was so exaggerating. It was actually kind of funny. And I'm like, Ryuk's not that scary. Like, I get it. He does look terrifying, but come on, dude. Like, you're pushing it. Like, I think Light and Mia are Light Turner and Light and Mia are roughly based off the original Light Yagami, while also having certain elements of Misa, but that's mostly with Mia. Essentially, that's kind of how it works. That's how I envision it, at least. So the scene where, you know, Light's meeting up with Ryuka, that didn't bother me too much. Another thing too, this movie did have a lot of elements making it into the rated R that we saw it was, and yeah, I get it, you know, they wanted to make it seem that way, and it wasn't as bad towards the second half, or not second half, but like the second and third parts, but I noticed, I felt like a lot of the time they were just doing this to push the R rating, like, hey guys, we're edgy here, yeah, you know, remember how Death Note was TV-14? Well, no, we're pushing it to TVMA, or rated R, and I was like, yeah, okay, like, that, I get it, you know, like, everyone's frustrated, you're gonna want to pull in some F-bombs here and there, but come on, this is pushing it too far. This doesn't even seem logical, even for something based off an anime. Okay, this doesn't seem all that wild, all that sensical, so
Yeah, it did feel like pushing it a little too far with the rated R element. You know, I understand why they did some stuff. There definitely is a lot of brutality here, but at the same time, you know, they didn't need to go all that far to enforce it that this movie's rated R. Like, you could have just had a rated R, keep it like a smaller rated R, but no, they wanted to go all out. They wanted to push it as far as they can. So yeah, I feel like, you know, because the original Death Note on Netflix and other streaming services, it's TV-14, aside from the last two episodes. So, you know, they still could have maybe appealed to more audiences without making it rated R. But whatever, people were still going to see it either way. Essentially, that factors into it. Yeah, the light and Mia, that was a huge con of the film. What else is there? There's plenty of other elements that, oh my gosh. That's just talking about the characters. We're going in at like, I don't know, like, okay, so I was talking, the introduction was like 3 minutes, and now 21 minutes of me just talking about the characters. Now it's going to get a little less detailed, because I had a lot to say about the characters. The plot is, like I said, there, you know, there were three acts of the film. The first act just felt too much. I get that it's an introduction act, but I feel like it wasn't as well handled as maybe, like, a second and third. But then when L came around, I was like, yeah, this is starting to get a little better. And especially the suspense aspect, I thought the music was very on and off. There were certain aspects where the music fit, and there were certain aspects where the music was just like, hey, yeah, you remember this one popular song? Why don't we just have it here for the sake of, especially during that roller coaster scene, I don't know. Or did I just say roller? No, the Ferris wheel scene. Yeah, so this movie did focus there on the, what do you call it? On the fact that, yeah, this is meant to, yeah, we're going to have a little more action than the original Death Note, because a lot of the original Death Note focuses a lot on the suspense, and they do have it in this film, but a fair portion of this film. I was kind of worried, though, because I was like, yeah, this is going to focus too much on the action. It does focus on suspense. It also focuses a lot on brutality. So there's that. It also goes to show it has the same message as the original Death Note, where too much power is going to make you go corrupt one way or the other, and as long as it retains that original message, it's fine, okay? You also get, like, an original 2 points, because as long as it has the same basic, you know, message of Death Note, it's all I need, okay? That's a huge factor. I'm happy they did implement that. Yeah, so the action was actually pretty good. The CGI, I felt, worked. What else is there? Yeah, the CGI worked, the action worked. The second half of the film, or no, where did you say, why do I keep saying second half? Second act of the film. Second act of the film, I feel, was a lot where the plot started to go down. We'd already had that established, you know, annoying relationship with Light and Mia. Stuff was starting to get a little more interesting. They have to kind of watch what they say now that Elle's kind of watching them and stuff. So I like how they did that. You have to be a little more considerate. And then the third act was, I think, like the Elle and Light, after everything after the Elle and Light encounter, where Elle's like, yeah, I know you're Kida. Just be prepared for what's to come. That's probably one of my favorite scenes in the whole film. It's just like, you don't see him out of nowhere. We do see L's strong sense of justice here, especially with his dialogue, with the way he acts. I really liked it. Light was just, yeah, well, Light's Light. He's not Light Yagami, so I'm going to give him the benefit of the doubt, but at the same time, if you just look at this as an independent film, yeah, he wasn't that great. Same with Mia. And yeah, it works. For the most part, fine. You can still bear through it. Third act of the film, the action, there was stuff I didn't even expect to go down with the way Light. Well, yeah, let's talk about the ending now. The ending, I can tell some people were going to be really confused about it. I personally think the ending was probably one of the best parts of the film, along with, you know, L and Ryuk and stuff. But the ending overall, the ending. Okay, so basically, a lot of people I can tell are confused about the ending. Like, yeah, this doesn't make sense. Why on earth is essentially, why is Light just getting it off this easy? How is L actually going to write Light's name? I like the fact that it kind of opens up to a mystery that, you know what, L does have that one page of the Death Note where, yeah, it's not burned, so it's still active. And because they've already burned one name. They already burned one name. Like, Mia already had burned Light's name. So, no more lives can really be saved anymore. So, whatever you write in that Death Note, they stay dead forever, essentially. So, that's basically it. L, I like what they had here. L saw what he had to do. L's probably revoked his detective position, but whatever. He still wants his way of getting justice. Light was in a coma in the hospital. Was able to actually trick his enemy into thinking, you should probably take the hit for this one right here. And that got me. That reminded me of the time in the original Death Note where Light kind of lost his memories to avoid suspicion anymore. So I thought that was interesting. That was also kind of an homage, I noticed. But maybe it's just me. I was a big fan of how they did that. The intelligent thing that, oh wow, we never noticed that. That's really smart of you, Light. And then, yeah, so that's one really smart part of Light, that he had this planned all the way through. That's kind of the basic thing they wanted to show us at the end of the film regarding Light. But at the same time, it's like a lot of the mistakes that he made in the beginning, that doesn't make all the more sense. But then again, you know, he was still kind of getting too crazy with power until he discovered about L. And then when L came around, he was a little more smarter and thinking more precise about it. So yeah, that's basically it. The movie didn't have as many of the fun mind games as the original anime had, because that's another reason why I love the original anime and manga so much. Plays with your mind a lot. That's one of my favorite parts of it. Yeah, so that's covering the plot, essentially. I like the ending, that it kind of leaves it up to interpretation. That, you know, what is L actually going to write his name? It also kind of shows, I don't think L wrote his name, because what's it? L sees that page, he's like, oh wow, I already know how this is gonna go. I already have an idea of the Death Note and stuff. So he gets the pen, he starts getting, he's about to write Light just so he can put an end to this corrupt justice. And then it looks like he kind of stops himself, and then it seems like he doesn't write it at all. He's about to, but he doesn't. And then Ryuk just starts laughing at the end of the film, just says, humans are so interesting. And then the movie ends, essentially. So I see it more so Ryuk is fascinated as, there are some humans that will kill another, but then there are some humans who, despite what they wanted this whole time, they're not going to kill someone. So that's how I saw it. It made sense to me personally, but maybe other people envision it differently, which is fine. You know, we all have our own ideas when seeing this film, because the ending, they don't directly tell you, and that's why I don't think there should be a sequel to this. It's because I like it when this ending is kind of open to interpretation. It gets the viewers thinking as well, and maybe if someone saw this film, but then they liked the ending, but then, you know, wanted to see, like more of this, they just watched the original Death Note adaptation, which is so much better done in this film. I cannot stress that enough. Original Death Note's way better, manga or anime, either or, is so good. that's covering the plot. What else is there? The L and Light rivalry, I liked how they handled that. It definitely did feel like, there was some level of tensity here, because, even though L is essentially kind of an antagonist here, he also has the strong sense of justice, whereas Light is kind of conflicted. L's a little more mature than Light, but also they're both childish in a sense because they both hate losing, and I really like that. I thought that was fine for the most part. What else is there? I covered the plot, I covered everything. The acting. The acting. For the most part, the actors did an okay job. Light's actor, I think, was mostly due to the writing. A lot of the writers kind of give him this unrealistic vision, even for something based off an anime. I feel like Light was an eh. Maybe could have picked someone else better for the role. Maybe could have picked some better writers, so you could at least pay homage to the original. Because I'm not gonna lie, if this was Light Yagami, if they actually did call him Light Yagami, that would literally be a disgrace to the original. Like, I hate to sound like a weeaboo here, but it would have been, because the way he was portrayed, it's like, this is not Light Yagami. You cannot tell me this is not Light Yagami. So it's a good thing they changed the name, because let's be real, what kind of American family has the last name Yagami? If you do, then whatever. But so Turner, they went for more of that obvious choice. But I also find that funny, because Turner, I kept thinking of Timmy Turner. I'm like, Light is just an average kid that no one under... Okay, I'll stop. But this video is just a ramble on fest, as you can tell. I covered basically a lot of it. As far as how the overall dialogue was, I thought the dialogue was okay. Everything with L was pretty good, with what Light was saying. Sometimes it felt like he was absolutely stupid. Sometimes it felt like he was a genius. It was kind of in that middle area, whatever. Light's still in high school here, but then again, he was still in high school in the original. He was a genius we all loved him for, so... I get why they did this here, because sometimes it might not always translate as well. Like, hey, why is he so smart? you know, and maybe it wants to make viewers understand a little more. But I can tell this is not going to, if their whole point of this was to get maybe newer viewers, like mainstream audiences into Death Note, I don't know if it's exactly going to work according to plan. I don't think anything's going to change because they're going to be like, yeah, this movie was average. The series probably ain't going to be that good. But all I'm saying is the series is way better. Like, legit, I would even go as far to say it's like the last 10 episodes, which is actually my least favorite part of the series. That's better than this movie because you know what? At least it flows well and at least it's well acted. Like, yeah. And at least we see Light fail. Here we just see Light almost being kind of hypocritical in a sense. And I don't really like that all that much. That's basically it. I said that like six times throughout this entire review, but this is all unscripted. I'm one take, you know, I've already recorded a review, but I didn't like how that turned out, so I'm re-recording it. It's around the same time as the original review anyway, so yeah, that's it. Probably not going to edit this video all that much because I don't have the patience or audacity to edit like a 30-minute video. So, yeah. Anyways, guys, thanks so much for watching this video. And if you did enjoy it, then be sure to drop a like, subscribe, comment your thoughts on the Death Note movie. Did you like it? Did you not like it? Do you think the movie gets too much hate like what I'm saying? Overall, I still see the movie as like a 6 or 6.5. I feel like people are trashing on this too much. So, yeah. Anyways, thank you all so much for watching. Ninja out. Peace, everybody.